Hey, good people. Today I'm going to show you how to use the Cramer's rule. Okay? If it's your first time here, please consider subscribing and make sure you watch till the end so that you can actually learn this. Okay? So today I'm actually going to show you how to use the Cramer's rule and solve a system of equation of two equations with two unknown. That's why we call it part one of two. Okay, next time we're actually going to make for you part two of two, whereby we're going to show you how to solve a system of equation of three equations with three unknown. Okay, that's it. So what are we actually going to do today? I'm going to show you how to solve a system of equation of two equations with two unknown. Okay, using Cramer's rule. Obviously, we first explain how to use Cramer's rule, and then I'm actually going to show you how to do calculations on it. Okay, so we first explain the rule, then I'll show you how to do calculations. Make sure that you watch till the end so that you can actually learn this. Okay, here we go. Let's consider the system. Pay attention to what I'm doing. Let's consider the system. This is our system here of two equations with two unknowns. Let's say a1x plus b1y is equal to c1. Okay, this is the first equation. Then we have a2x plus b2y is equal to c2. So what is actually happening here? For you to solve the system above using Cramer's rule, we follow the steps below. The first step, we need to find the determinant of the whole system, okay, which is actually delta. Okay, how do you find the determinant of the whole system? You take this constant which are in front of x and y. Okay, so you take your a1, a2, then b1, b2, and for you to get this determinant, you need to actually do this product, I mean a1 b2 minus this product a2 b1. Okay, so we do a1 times b2 minus a2 times b1. This is the step number one. We first find the determinant of the whole system. Then step number two, which is our second step, we need to find delta x. How do you find delta x? We're still taking coefficients that are in front of variable, but as we're looking for delta s, in front of x's, we don't take the numbers in front of x's. Instead, we take the numbers which are on the second member of the equation. Okay, so we start by c1, c2, then we take the rest, okay, following the order, which is b1, b2. Okay, we actually do what we did previously. So you do your product. This will give you c1 times b2 minus c2 b1. After doing this, you can actually calculate your x. How do you calculate your x? By doing delta x over delta. Okay, that's how you apply your Cramer's rule. The third step, you need to find your delta y. Same apply, we copy constant in front of unknowns or in front of variables in this order. So you start by your a1, a2. Same apply, this time instead of taking constant that are in front of y, we take the constant which are on the other member of the equation, which is c1, c2. From here we can apply our rule of determinant. Okay, this product minus this one, so it's actually going to be equal to what? It's a1 c2 minus a2 C1. Having delta Y, we can actually find Y. Okay, your Y will be equal to delta Y over delta. Okay, and then there is one more thing. After finding your X and Y, you must verify if your values are right or not. How do you verify? By substituting them in the given equation, in the given system of equation. That's it. Okay, now that you can be able to find your delta, okay, delta X, delta Y, and to find X and Y, there is a question that we're going to put on the board. I'll do calculation and show you how to solve. This is the question we're actually going to solve, okay? I'll go through the question, read it for you, do calculations so that you can also be able to do calculation on the Cramer's rule, okay? Make sure you pay attention and watch till the end. Here we go. The system of equation is equation 1, x plus y is equal to 3. Equation 2, 2x minus 3y is equal to minus 4. The question is asking you to solve for x and y using the Cramer's rule, okay? Here we go. The first thing to do is to find the determinant of the whole system, okay? We actually copy constant data in front of variables on the first member of our system of equations, okay? So we have 1, 2, and we have 1 and minus 3. You know the rule. This times this minus this times this, okay? So we actually have 1 times minus 3 minus 2 into 1. This gives you what? This is minus 3 minus 2, which is equal to minus 5. This is our step number 1. Step number 2, we need to find delta x. How do you get delta x? You copy constant data in front of variable in the very same order, but please, wherever there is x, we take constant which are on the second member of our system, okay? So which means that we start by 3 and minus 4, and then we continue. We take the y's now, which is 1 and minus 3. This will actually give you what? This is 3 times minus 3 minus of the formula into minus 4 times 1. We do our calculations, okay? Minus 3 times 3 is equal to minus 9. This becomes plus 4, which is equal to minus 5. Okay? From here, we can actually get our x. Our x will be what? Delta x over value of delta. How much is delta x? Your delta x is minus 5. And your delta is also minus 5. So you're dividing the same number, we get 1. Minus 5 over minus 5 is equal to 1. Then our third step, we need to find delta y. Okay? How do you actually get your delta y? You know that we copy constant which are in front of variable in this order, but this time, whatever constant that is in front of y won't be taken. Instead, we're going to take constant which are on the second member of our equation. So here we are, we take 1, 2, we don't take what is in front of y. Why? Because we're looking for delta y. So we take the constant on the other side, which is 3 and minus 4. This will actually give you what? We do our usual calculations. So this is 1 times minus 4, minus of the formula, minus 2 times 3. Okay, 1 times minus 4 is equal to minus 4, minus of the formula, 2 times 3 is actually 6, and minus 4 minus 6 is equal to minus 10. Having this, we can actually get our y, okay? Our y will be what? Delta y over value of delta. How much is our delta y, please? It's minus 10. How much is the value of delta, which is the determinant of the whole system? It's minus 5. Minus 10 over minus 5 is equal to 2. Okay, so as conclusion, your x is equal to 1 and your y is equal to 2. This is what the question was asking you to do. But remember that we're asking that you should verify your answer to confirm that the calculation that you did are actually right. How do you verify your answer? You need to replace this value into the given system of equation. Here we go. Okay, x is equal to 1, so we do 1, y is equal to 2, okay, this must give you 3, we verify the first equation, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3, 3 is equal to 3, this is right, okay, this very same two values should verify the second equation at the same time, okay, let us verify, so you have 2, x is 1, we actually replacing here, minus 3. Y is actually 2, this must give you minus 4. This will actually, 2 times 1 is equal to 2, okay? Minus 3 times 2 is equal to minus 6, this must give us negative 4. 2 minus 6 is equal to minus 4, so minus 4 is equal to minus 4, okay? You can clearly see that these two values verify at the same time our two equation, okay, which means that the calculation that we did are actually right. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you subscribe and don't forget that I need your comment on the comment box, okay? See you on the next video.